to everybody concerned over there. Third will go to number 13, which will be Miss Khalifa, and back in fourth, number 2, Movie Magic. So if you're holding on to a quartet ticket over here, I think go and get the security team, because this is going to pay absolute rockets.
And returning to the winners and closer, third win this afternoon for trainer Paul Matchett, taking the training honours here at the VAAL with three winners to his credit. Now and forever, number 10 is the winner for apprentice Cabello Marzignani, owned by Farley Bronckhorst and Mr. H.L. Nietling, and bred by Mr. R.G. Pinar. 25,000 rand by Now and Forever, three-year-old bay gelding by Diwali, out of the goalkeeper mare Free Racer. Second was number 11, Jenny McGee for the Cooney De Beer Stable. They've had a fascinating day today. Well done to Cooney and his stables out here at the VAAL. Third flashing up was 13, Miss Khalifa. Got up into third ahead of number 2, Movie Magic, into fourth. Fifth was 9, Sleep in Seattle. So those are the numbers for the final race, 10, 11, 13, 2 and 9. Thanks for joining us at the VAAL for this Tuesday racing. Please wait for the all clear. Should be given shortly. We're back here on Thursday and at Turf Fontaine on Sunday. Just a week left of the current racing season. And surprisingly, both the jockeys that are heading the top of the log drew blanks out here at the VAAL today. Both Lyle and Muzzy drawing the blanks. And the latest state of affairs, Lyle Hewitson going into tomorrow has 215 winners for the season, with Muzzy Yanni on 206. There's 9 winners in it, and there is just 9 days remaining.
The last race has been won by number 10, Now and Forever, after a cracking run not too long ago behind King of the Delta from the Stuart Pettigrew yard. Has certainly romped in no uncertain terms. A top ride from Cabela Matsinyani. Well done to the Paul Matchett team. Well done to Farnie Bronkhorst, who has another winner as well. And good to ride in these silks, because I know that Farnie invests a lot of money into the game, and I'm sure it's a privilege riding a winner for him.
Yes, you know, it's always a privilege to ride winners for owners like this, and you know, big thanks to them for the support and for believing me in me. And you know, this horse on penultimate, I knew he had a big chance with a little bit of distance again, 1400. He will sit easy, and you know, I was just confident he just needed that.
I thought it was a superb ride from you. I haven't been able to catch up with you after your little trip to France. Did you enjoy it over there? I'm sure it's something that you don't get to see every day. Tell the viewers about it.
No, you know, it was a great experience. I mean, just to get that experience of seeing how other countries are doing in racing, and you know, the courses that are very lovely, and you know, it's just magnificent to be just out there, you know, just representing South Africa. And you know, it's just everything with that trip. It was just a very educational trip, and I learned a lot from it, and you know, just to get that experience too.
Well done, Cabela. You're a man full of talent, and you certainly flew the South African flag high, and we're very proud of you back at home, and long may the winners continue.
Yes, big thanks, and once again to Mr. Matchett, Mr. Bronkhorst, well done to them, to the whole team back home, and to my sponsor, Winning Farm.
Good. What number is it?
51.
Lovely, keep it up. Well done, Cabela. Top ride. I was just chatting to the guys earlier on. You really won my presenting job, eh? Because this is the third time we've spoken to you throughout the afternoon. And you guys have done a magnificent job. I thought all your horses looked a picture, and you guys can be very proud.
Yeah, I'm very proud of our stable. I'm very happy with our stable, the way his performance. And I also want to thank Mr. Matchett for his performance. And also thank you to our owner, Farnie Bronkhorst. And thank you very much to the team I work with. Thank you, guys.
You've done a super job. I really hope that you guys get rewarded for what you guys have done this afternoon. It's never easy having three winners, but you've done it. So well done to you. And please, when you go back home, tell Mr. Matchett as well that from everybody at the VAAL, we're very proud of him.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Well done. Well done. Well done to all the guys involved in this. Obviously, I know there's a lot of work. I know I keep touching on it. It might sound like a stuck record, but I don't think people realize what goes into a racehorse getting to the racetrack, and especially middle of winter out here at the VAAL. I know that it gets very cold out here. Just for the international viewers, I'm sure they experience the same sort of conditions. But our horses get thick coats, and let me tell you, the Paul Matchett yard have groomed their horses to perfection. Well done to all concerned. Of course, to Cabello, to Farnie Bronkhorst, and to the big boss himself, Paul Matchett. Top, top stuff. You'll be proud of this. And that just leads me to say thank you to Nico upstairs. Thank you to Sean and everybody behind the scenes, the guys in the Teletrack studios, the guy in the Betting World studio. I think, in fact, that may not be a guy. That'll be Erica behind the scenes. So I'll have to deal with that off air. But thank you very much to her. And thank you to Sean, everybody in the Obie van. It's been a tremendous day out, champ. And of course, to you as the punter, thank you for your hard work. Thank you for your loyal support. From myself, Brandon, good night.
At this time round, ready and racing away from that 1400-meter position. Miss Khalif, if anything, was slightly slow to get going. Dread the Dragon jumped away well with Now and Forever. Sleep in Seattle's up there on the outside of them with Jenny McGee. Chip off the old block is behind those. Further down towards their inside, Golden Spiral.